Good morning, one and all. Myself, Dr. Swati. So in the previous course content, you might have seen some of the details of the anti-Parkinsonism drugs, like introduction, pathophysiology of the disease, and you might have also seen the pharmacological actions, classification, therapeutic classification, and also chemistry of the some of the agents like carbidopa as well as levodopa. So in this video, I'll be detailing about chemistry of the some of the dopaminergic agonists. So let us start with the chemistry of the bromocriptine. Bromocriptine is a dopaminergic agonist. So you can see the structure of the bromocriptine. So as such, it is available in a salt form. That is, in combination with the mesylate, it is available. So the nomenclature is 5'S(2-bromo)12-hydroxy. 2'-methyl ethyl 5'-2-methyl propyl. So this is propyl group is there here, and this is propyl group, methyl propyl group, and ergotamine 3'-6'-18 trione methane sulfonate. So you can see, as per the nomenclature, there are 3 ones are there. So this is 1 one here and here as well as here. Okay, so and it is a methone sulfonate derivative. So if you look at the little chemistry of this molecule, this is actually derived from ergot alkaloid, which is having dopaminergic activity. So we can get this bromocriptine from ergotamine upon treatment with N-bromosuccinamide. Ergocriptine itself is a semisynthetic derivative of the natural alkaloid ergocriptine. So which is this upon treatment with N-bromosuccinamide. We can get bromocriptine. As we all know, N-bromosuccinamide is a non-brominating agent. So when we treat it with N-bromosuccinamide, ergocriptine, here the bromine will be added to the ergocriptine. So thus we get finally bromocriptine. So that is how we can synthesize bromocriptine from ergocriptine upon treatment with the a bromination reaction by using N-bromosuccinamide as the reagent. So now coming to its metabolic pathway. The major metabolic pathway is because of the presence of this amide functional group. As you have seen here, COOH, amide functional group is there. So generally, compounds which are having amide functional group, they are hydrolyzed by the action of a CYP450 isoform, which is known for the hydrolysis is 3A4 form. So here also with bromocriptine, same happens. This amide group present in bromocriptine undergo hydrolysis in the presence of CYP3A4. So as a result of this amide hydrolysis, we get here a carboxylic acid derivative, which is called as a lysergic acid, and also a peptide will be obtained. So both the lysergic acid as well as peptide molecules which are obtained are non-toxic as well as inactive also. So that is how the principal metabolic pathway for the bromocriptine is hydrolysis reaction. It's a phase 1 reaction. Coming to the other agent, apomorphine is also a dopaminergic agonist. So let us deal with the chemistry of the apomorphine. So you can see the structure of the apomorphine. So this molecule is having 4 ring systems. So 3 6 member rings are fused linearly, and 1 benzenoid ring system is fused angularly. And also one of the benzene ring system having catechol like structure. So it is having 2 ortho hydroxy functionalities, and out of 3 linearly fused ring system, 1 is a reduced pyridine ring system which is having N methyl group, and this is the nomenclature of the apomorphine. So if you look at the structure activity relationship of this particular molecule, the above structure is the dopamine structure, it is a dopaminic structure. So having the catechol ring system, and having a 2 ethyl carbon chain followed by a amine functionality, primary amine functionality. So the above structure is the structure of the dopamine, and you can also see the structure of the apomorphine. So because of this, it's a structural resemblance with the dopamine. Where the catechol group is also present in case of apomorphine, just similar to dopamine, and also the 2 carbon link between the benzene ring, that is catechol ring, and the primary amine group is also maintained in case of apomorphine. Only the difference is here the two carbon distance between the catechol ring and the amine group is maintained in the form of cyclic ring system, and in case of dopamine it is primary amine group is present, while in case of apomorphine it is a tertiary amine group. The nitrogen is present in the form of a reduced bridine ring system and it is further substituted. So because of its structural resemblance with the dopaminergic dopamine structure, so the apomorphine will go and bind on the same pocket on the receptor site, dopamine receptor site. And based on the conformational study, it was concluded that the trans alpha tautomer, rotamer of the apomorphine is having structural resemblance with the dopamine, so which is known to have dopaminergic agonistic activity, just similar to that of the natural agonist dopamine. So coming to the synthesis of the apomorphine, apomorphine can be easily synthesized from morphine. So this is the structure of morphine. So when acid hydrolysis is performed for the morphine, we get some of the ring systems will undergo that, particularly a reduced pyridine ring, furan ring system, which is present in morphine, will undergo cleavage. So as a result of which we'll be getting here two hydroxy groups of the catechol. So that is how we finally get the apomorphine. Coming to the metabolic pathway of the apomorphine, so as we all know, there are two different kinds of the metabolic pathways, phase 1 reactions as well as phase 2 reactions. So as a result of phase 1 reactions, apomorphine gets converted to, it will undergo N-demethylation, and as a result of N-demethylation, the methyl group will be removed, so as a result of which we'll be getting norepomorphine. And as such, apomorphine can also undergo phase 2 conjugation reactions, like it can undergo glucuronidation reaction, so that the oxygen or catechol oxygens of the apomorphine will combine with the glucuronic acid and they give corresponding O-glucuronide, and also the nitrogen of the reduced pyridine ring system of the apomorphine also undergo glucuronic acid conjugation and gives N-glucuronide. Similarly, the molecule also undergo phase 2 sulfation reaction, so where there is chances of formation of O sulfate as well as corresponding N sulfate as the phase 2 metabolites. And as I said earlier, it will undergo phase 1 reaction, that is N-demethylation, and it gives norepomorphine, and the resulting nor derivative also undergo both glucuronidation as well as sulfonation. So as a result of sulfation, it gives O sulfate. As a result of glucuronic acid conjugation, it gives both the O-glucuronide as well as the norepomorphine N-glucuronide. So phase 1 reaction is the N-demethylation reaction, and phase 2 reactions are the its ability of the both apomorphine as well as norepomorphine to give corresponding glucuronic acid derivatives as well as the sulfate derivatives. So this is the overall metabolic pathway of the apomorphine. Thank you very much.